Linda presents this unabridged recording of
Tom Gates' Spectacular School Trip, Really? By Liz Pichon, read by Mathew Baynton. Whatever you do, don't look at the achievement chart. It's not like I meant to get three sad faces. It just sort of happened. Marcus didn't help much. He's only got one sad face. Or two if you count his actual face. And the worst part is, none of them were my fault. It's true. I got this sad face in quiet time. I was just doodling a nice picture of Mr. Fullerman with big eyes, teeth and hair, lots of it, when Marcus Meldrew, who's a nosy Parker, started laughing so loudly.
You'll get in trouble if Mr. Fullerman sees that.
Shh! He won't see it if you keep quiet, I said. Too late.
Tom, that's one sad face for you.
Oh! See what I mean? Not my fault. Then, last week, I was round at Derek's house getting my homework done on time, for a change, when Rooster jumped up, grabbed it, then ran off. Mr. Fullerman was not impressed.
So let me get this right. The dog ate your homework again?
Yes, sir, I said. It's true.
That's your second sad face of the term, Tom.
Oh! I couldn't believe I had two sad faces. Then, this morning, I woke up really early for school and went to meet Derek, who was surprised to see me on time. Tom, you're here. Don't sound so surprised. Come on, let's go. We don't want to be late, I said. Derek and I did fast walking and tried not to get distracted by anything. Then Derek suddenly stopped and shouted,
Hey, Tom, look what I found. 50p.
We did a high five and went straight to the shop. But deciding what to buy was tricky. Should we get one packet of cheesy puffs and two fruit chews? Or how about one caramel wafer to share?
Maybe a whole bag of broken biscuits,
Derek suggested, which was a good idea. But the shopkeeper spotted us checking which bag was the biggest and said,
Come on, you two, they're all the same size.
They're not the same size. Everybody knows that. While I checked the bags, Derek spotted that the latest copy of Rock Weekly had Dude 3 on the cover.
Tom, look at this!
So, we took a sneaky peek through the whole magazine while the queue went down, then decided to buy one caramel wafer to share. It's a good plan, Derek agreed. But when we got to the front of the queue, all the wafers had gone, which was a disaster!
No!
Luckily, the shopkeeper saved the day and found another box, so we got a wafer after all. That's a relief, Derek said, and I agreed. I split the wafer in two and enjoyed eating it slowly. The trouble was, we spent so much time in the shop that we missed the start of school.
Ding, 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 ding.
Uh-oh. You're late, Tom. That's three sad faces now.
But, sir, I say in a please don't give me another sad face kind of way.
If you get one more sad face, Tom, do you know what will happen?
Mr. Fullerman asks.
Sort of, sir, I reply.
Then Marcus sticks up his hand and starts saying,
Sir, sir, I know what will happen.
Marcus is so annoying.
He'll get a detention, sir, and he'll have to do lots of extra homework too.
Thanks for reminding me, Marcus, I say.
Any time.
Smug.
You can put your hand down, Marcus, right down. As I was saying, anyone with four sad faces will not be allowed to go on the school trip,
Mr. Fullerman tells us.
School trip? What school trip?
I ask.
The school trip that you won't be going on with your four sad faces, Marcus says. So I point out, I don't have four sad faces, Marcus. Yet, he adds.
Quiet down. I'll tell you more about the school trip later. Right now, here's something else to look forward to. This week's homework.
Ah, we all groan.
It's very special homework,
Mr. Fullerman says, trying to make it sound interesting.
Like that even exists,
I whisper to Amy.
It's going to be displayed for the school open day, when parents and carers come to look around our fantastic school and see if their own children would love it here. And who wouldn't want to come to Oakfield School, right, Class 5F?
Silence. Then Marcus sticks up his hand and says,
Sir, sir, I can tell them how great this school is.
That's excellent, Marcus. I'm sure we can all think of lovely things to say about the school.
Silence.
And I can tell them all about the achievement chart and how you can't ever go on a school trip if you have three sad faces, sir,
Marcus says, looking at me.
It's actually four sad faces, Marcus, Mr. Fullerman corrects him.
I think it should be three, sir, because three sad faces means you haven't been very good at all, and three is my lucky number,
Marcus replies. You can't change the rules, Marcus, Amy tells him. Marcus is trying to stop me going on the school trip, but that's not going to happen.
Now, Class 5F, listen carefully. Your homework is...
I hope it's not going to be hard. I can't get another sad face for getting it wrong.
I whisper.
I'd like you to draw a poster.
A what?
A poster all about the things you like.
I must be dreaming. My homework is to draw a poster.
Yes! This is brilliant! It's the best homework ever!
Then Mr. Fullerman says,
That reminds me, Tom. I know you like drawing and doodling.
Sometimes, sir.
Well, the council have created a special doodle wall just for kids like you to draw on.
That's amazing. Where is it, sir?
The address is on this leaflet. The council wants to encourage children to be creative and draw in this one special place where it's allowed, so it's not graffiti.
Mr. Fullerman passes out leaflets showing where the wall is.
Wow! My homework is a poster and there's an actual doodle wall to draw on too. How good is that?
Though Amy doesn't look that happy, Marcus looks the same as usual.
I can't wait to go to the doodle wall. How about you?
I ask Amy. I'm not bothered. Drawing's not my thing, she tells me. So I say,
Come on, Amy, anyone can draw. Even Marcus can doodle. Look.
Don't ask me what it is, though, I point out as Marcus is busy.
I think I'll go to the wall after school and draw this. It's good, isn't it?
Marcus shows us his drawing.
What is it?
Amy asks.
Isn't it obvious?
Marcus sighs.
A self-portrait? I say.
Very funny, Tom. I'm going to be the first person to draw on the doodle wall. Then everyone will see how good I am,
he boasts.
What happens if I get there before you, Marcus?
I ask him.
You won't, Tom, because you're late for everything, and that's why you've got four sad faces.
Actually, I've only got three sad faces, I correct him.
For now,
he adds, smiling.
Then Amy says, Maybe I will go to the wall after all. I can copy your doodle style, Tom, if that's okay.
Sure, I say, slightly surprised. Marcus covers his work.
Don't even think about copying my style.
I'll try not to, Amy sighs.
Hey, Tom, can you do one of your doodles?
She wonders. So I write my name and draw around it.
Whoa, you're so fast. That's great.
Amy says when I finish.
It's not that good,
Marcus grumbles. We ignore him. Why don't we all go to the doodle wall after school together with Derek? I'm sure one of my parents will drive us, I say confidently. I hope they will. I'm in, Amy tells me. I'm out, but don't worry about me. I'll still be at the wall before both of you, Marcus says smugly. No one's worried about you, Marcus, Amy tells him. My drawings are amazing, aren't they? Yes, Marcus, you're a genius, I say. I know. He's not, but sometimes it's just easier to agree. Besides, I've got far more important things to think about now, like 1. Going to the doodle wall after school. 2. Telling Derek that we're going to the doodle wall so he can come too. 3. Doing my poster homework early. 4. Impressing Mum and Dad with my early poster homework so they'll drive us to the doodle wall. 5. Getting a good after-school snack. That might be at the top of my list, if I'm honest. Once I'm home, I get busy with my homework, which seems to surprise Mum. Hi, Tom. You do know you're missing Crazy Fruit Bunch on TV right now, don't you? Thanks, Mum, but I'm doing my homework early, I say, hoping she'll be super impressed. Wow, well done. I'm impressed. Result. Did I just hear you say you're doing your homework early, Tom? Dad asks. Yes, I've nearly finished it too. A little hard work never hurt anyone. I can't believe I just said that. But I really want to get to the doodle wall before Marcus does. It's all down to good parenting, Dad whispers. Mum, Dad? Yes, Tom. As I've finished my homework early and I'm your favourite child, can you take me to the new doodle wall? Doodle wall? Isn't that just graffiti? Dad asks. No, it's official. Mr Fullerman gave us a leaflet, see? Everyone's going after school, I explain. I don't see why not, Tom, Mum says. I can take you in the new car. We have a new car.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.